Hey, I'm Paul Esteves. I'm a freelance motion designer and CG artist. Currently, I'm based in Munich, Germany, but originally I'm from South Africa. And I'm excited to share a little bit about how I use Houdini in my day-to-day workflow. So the way that I learned Houdini was a little bit based on inspiration. I was working at a big company using Cinema 4D in my day-to-day, and I'd never heard of Houdini. But the technical director at the company, he used Houdini. He was the only one in the team. But the things that I saw on his screen were really impressive, and I really enjoyed seeing what he was creating in Houdini. And so at night, after I put the kids to bed and the wife was asleep, I started just watching some videos and opening the apprentice version and just kind of tinkering and playing and seeing what it was all about. And after I watched enough videos, I realized that this was the software that I wanted to use. And so I kind of dived headfirst into it and would run simulations during the day while I was at work and come back and super excited to see what results I got. And that was my venture into Houdini. Okay, so you've just started Houdini and you've opened it up and now you're wondering, okay, what do I do? So here are my top 5 suggestions of how to make something very fun, very fast. The first one is to jump over to sideeffects.com and go into their learning paths. If you look on that tab, you'll find a whole bunch of cool curated tutorials, and most of them are free. The one that I really suggest, and this is number 2, is Houdini Isn't Scary. This is like a full introduction course, gets you going, it makes some cool things. It's really easy. Watch this and you're already on your way to a very cool journey. The third thing that you can do is go over to CG Wiki. Matt Estella does great HIP files and he's got GIFs everywhere, lots of cool reading you can do, but you can download his HIP files, you can open them, and you've already got something, a base that you can play with. Change parameters, see what you can do, move the camera around, put some lights, render it, and you're good to go. Number 4 is use Vellum. Vellum is super fast, it's super fun. You can use the configure balloon to make some squishy soft bodies, or you can use Vellum cloth and you can make some beautiful cloth flying around. It's really simple to get started.
And number 5, a little self-promotion, but you can check out my social media. I put out short reels of 30 to 60 seconds showing the different nodes and what they can do. Possibly it'll help give you an overview of some of the nodes you haven't yet used.
So possibly you've jumped into Houdini and you've started learning, but you want to learn faster. What's the best way to get good quickly? And although I don't think there's a fast track to learning Houdini, it's a slow and steady journey. Something that's really helped me is to learn in community, whether that be on Discord or OddForce, whether it be with a Mardini challenge where there's people doing the same thing as you and you can learn from other people. I find when we learn in community, we can learn a lot quicker and a lot faster. And so I find that social media is a fun way for me to learn. So I can put things out there, whether it be on TikTok or on Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram. Then people feedback and say, oh, this is a cool node. Here's something that I've done with it. And I may have never thought of that, but they had. And so we can learn from other people. And there's websites and there's Discords and Slack channels where people are really helpful. And if I get stuck on a node that I'm trying to make a video on, I can ask for help and somebody will help me and show me things that I didn't know before. And that's a great way for me to learn so that I'm not isolated trying to learn Houdini on my own, because I don't think that's the best way to learn. So maybe you've done some Houdini, you've got it under your belt and you've got some skills, but you're struggling to find some works. Maybe you're a freelancer and you're looking for studios. Maybe you're just looking for a full-time job, but you're wondering, how do I get that? So this is just my personal experience of the kind of my journey and how what I think has worked for me and what I've seen work for some friends of mine in the same position. And that is to put out like a bit of your process, not just final artwork, because there's a lot of great final artwork out there. But what I've found works is to show people that I know a little bit about how Houdini works and to show them the nodes that connect to each other and how I connect things together, so that people that are maybe looking, whether it be a studio or a company, they can see my process and see, oh, this guy can fit into our production or our pipeline. And so as you're building a reel, don't only put in final artwork, but maybe put in a little bit of the process. Houdini artists are well sought after at the moment. I'm constantly being asked, like, can I work on something? We need a Houdini artist. But if they don't know you exist, it's hard for them to connect with you. So put out content that people can see that you're using Houdini, that you know Houdini, and people will then contact you because they can see that you're proficient in what you're doing. So maybe some final thoughts that if you're getting into Houdini, maybe you've been using Houdini, but you haven't really been engaging in social media or on forums, I would encourage you to do that. Tag me in some of your posts, come share it with other people, with friends. Let's grow as a community, let's get better together, and let's share our work with one another so that we grow together.